the aperture we're doing. Make sense? All right. There are two types of administration. The first one is called independent administration. The second one is called dependent administration. The first one is pretty straightforward. Independent administration means that they don't have any core supervision in the decision making. They can make decisions on their own and move forward. In an independent, a dependent administration, it means that they can make decisions, but the court will have to approve them. It's like I'm making sure that the decision you make makes sense for the estate. Every decision that the PR makes is for the benefit of the estate, not for their own benefit. So if they do things just for their own benefit, they can get into big trouble. So I always like to talk to PRs and mention the word fiduciary. Fiduciary is kind of scary. So I say, Mr. Johns, you have a fiduciary responsibility to the estate. This is why it's so important to always list your real property. Never sell it to an investor because you can get into hot water. If something goes wrong, now you're liable for it. So now I position myself as a listing agent, especially. So now I can say, I'm certified in this niche. The certification makes a huge difference. Certifications is basically a marketing tool. You guys have different certifications in your career, and that gives you the edge over someone who doesn't. So it does help. It really makes you different. All right, now, this is how the whole probate thing flows. Oh, this is not the flow. This is partners. Let's talk about partners. Andrew Carnegie said, I'd rather make 1% of 1,000 people than make 100% of one person. What does that mean? That means that the more partners you have, the more streams of income you develop. This is why wealthy people make so much money, because they have multiple streams of income. It means they have multiple partners. So let me give you some partners that you want to build a relationship in this niche. The first one is attorneys. You do want to talk to attorneys. And what do attorneys want at the end of the day?
Results.
No. Beyond that.
Money.
Come on, this is the elephant in the room. So money. Now, you don't want to give a new commission check. However, if this attorney is licensed with the state of Texas, I can give him a referral fee. And I'm okay with that, and I'm within the legal boundaries. Okay? So, talking to an attorney, find out where they are, do they have a license, do they don't. And I'll let you be creative on your own mind. It's always creative strategy. Everyone wins. A partnership is a lot to win. Another good partner to have is paralegals. They do all the work for the attorneys, so they know what's going on every day. Another good partner will be CPAs, financial planners, bookkeepers, because they're the ones that's going to do they're going to do the filing, the tax filing for the estate, so they know what's going on. Charitable organizations. A lot of people like to donate for different causes. Now, if I am the American Cancer Society and someone donates a house, do I want the house or do I want the cash? So start talking to these organizations, Boy Scouts of America, Girl Scouts of America, American Cancer Society, Parkinson's Society. I mean, there's so many organizations out there. And introduce yourself, put your business card in front of them. And if you ever get a donation of a property, call me. I'll make sure we get the top dollar for it so you can have the funds available for your next project. And can you make a donation back to them? Think about this. I am a very creative man. If you're not gonna do business, I wanna make sure you win. So if I'm working with a society, I'll say, look, let me list the property for you. And when we close the deal, I'd like to make a donation for the organization. So I can donate 300, 500 bucks. It's a write-off for my business. And guess what? If I give them money, guess what's gonna happen next?
They're gonna give you referrals.
It's called the law of reciprocation. If I give you something, nature says, I'm gonna reciprocate back. It's like a dance, but you have to go out and ask to dance. Don't wait for them because they're not gonna come. You have to be the one out there, pushing this. And assisted living communities. I was leaving the hotel this morning, not too far from here, and there was a huge building, it's a senior living. I just looked at this thing, massive building, I'm thinking, how many people are living there? And remember, in the assisted living community, the person, they're elderly, they need more care, so there's a high rotation because they're passing on. So if you have a relationship with this person, when the person passes on, they can pass the information to their loved ones. So as they begin the probate process, you can help them also. So it's a really cool niche. So how the money can be made in this thing. All right, the probate process. Everything is filed at the local probate court. In Texas, you can file it yourself or you can hire an attorney. Whether you're doing the paperwork yourself or the attorney is doing it for you, the paperwork is filed to the probate court, and as soon as it is filed to the court, it becomes a public record. What's the name of the probate lead? What's the name of the document?
Petition
for probate. So now the petition for probate becomes public record. You walk into the court, you pull that, and now you find out who the attorney, who died, address, phone numbers, all kinds of stuff. And that is your lead. You all with me? Okay, so it's time to go prospecting. Who are we going to contact first, the PR or the attorney? The PR. How many times? I like that. I submit until I become a pest. At least six to eight. You do 6 to 8, you'll get that appointment. You'll get in there. And then let's say you try 15 times and you are finally fed up with this lead, you're going to trash it. But before you trash it, you do a Hail Mary pass. Who am I going to call? The attorney. That's my last resource. Because most likely, that attorney knows of another realtor. I can promise you that. They know realtors. So if I don't know this attorney, that'll be my last phone call I'm going to make. And when I'm ready to make that phone call, be very attorney language. It's like, may I speak to Bob? Who is this? This is Mike. What is this about? It's about the estate of James Smith, case number 12345. Is he available? He said, can I help you with something? No, you can't unless you're the attorney of record. I need to talk to the attorney of record if he's the only one showing up the paperwork. What do I sound like?
You know what you're talking about.
Besides that, I sound like another attorney, doesn't it?
Yeah.
So now they're going to put Bob on the phone. Hey, this is Bob. Mr. Smith, how are you? But that's how you want to be ready to go, to the point, so you can get through the gatekeeper. Because the gatekeepers are pretty good sometimes. Make sense? All right, so this is the fun part. This is a petition for probate from the state of Texas. Let me walk you through it. So when you go to the courthouse, you pull the record, and you see this. I know it's kind of small, but let's go through it. First thing, name of the deceased, Melvin. Okay? Reba is the applicant, which means Reba is the one asking the court to be the personal representative. Is she guaranteed to get the job, yes or no? Not guaranteed. They can put somebody else. What if she has a criminal record? She will definitely not be one. So they have to make sure this person is qualified for the job. Next, the applicant lives at 12719 Gotham, Houston, Texas. So this is the property, the applicant. So this is Reba's address. Now I can go knock on her door, I can send her a letter, I can send her all kinds of stuff. Is it easy so far? Oh, hold on, let me go back up here. The decedent died on 2011 at St. Luke's Episcopal Hospital at the age of 57. What a young guy. Okay, next page. Decedent and his wife Reba. Oh, it's his wife. Okay. And they live in the same address. So we know that there's real estate. And he says the probable value of this property is $96,000. So now I know for a fact it's real property. Okay, let me stop here. How many of you guys think this is a good lead? Show hands. It's a good lead. How many of you guys are like, I don't think so. Nobody? Okay. Well, I've seen some realtors going, I don't think it's a good lead because the wife is still alive. So what are the odds of she selling the house? High or low?
Well, it depends.
Why high?
She may want to downsize or can't afford it or too much maintenance.
Let me start with this. The moment he passed away, half the income disappeared. Isn't that crazy?
Especially at that age.
So that is a very good lead for the main reason. Income's gone. Now she's like, how am I going to sustain? And then that's when the kids come in, mom, why don't you come and move in with us, or let's buy something small. So there's relocation. If the spouse is still alive, doesn't mean it's a bad deal. It's just keep that in mind, half of the income is gone in that case.
The dollar figure, that's just something that she came up with?
The attorney. Okay. The attorney put that as a... So never trust that number. Never. Always ask the DR to have an appraised value on the property. Because remember, they have a fiduciary responsibility. Okay? So there is the phone, I mean, there's the address. And again, here's the address again of Reba. And here's the attorney's information, phone number, address, and everything. So how difficult is this niche market, guys? Now I see smiles, finally. Texas is a tough crowd, but that's okay. Now you see, it's pretty straightforward. Can you do this? Can you go to the courthouse and pull this business and start your prospect?
I didn't go through this process to get it, but I did just Friday get, I got referred by somebody to the lady passed away. Unexpectedly, her sister, brother, out of state, they're here. And I went and met with them Friday morning. They were, had talked to another realtor, but they were having to deal with all her stuff. So I followed up later. I have connections with people that do that kind of clean out, all this kind of stuff. And I sensed that they wanted one person to be more in control. Even though when I was talking to them, I said, you know, you hire them, I can find them for you, you hire them, you pay them.
Yeah.
Later I got to thinking, you know, that's not the way they wanted it. So I called them back up and I said, I'll be responsible, I'll do it. And they got a rate for $75 an hour from this person that was going to do that. And I was like, whoa, that's a lot of money. And they told her, she told them that it could be almost $5,000 just to get rid of her stuff. That all they wanted to do is donate it. And so I got to thinking and I said, okay, I'll do it and I'll do it for $50. I got the job.
Yeah.
I'm not going to do the work, but I know somebody who's going to do it and she's going to do it. I told her I'd pay her $35.
There you go, you got a spread going on.
But I'm going to oversee it and it's going to get done.
Stay still is a glorified garage sale. That's really what it is.
Well, it's easy. This part's easy because they just want to donate.
Oh, that's beautiful.
You know, so that's, you know, we don't have to go through it.
So all you have to do is literally just take the assets and donate them?
Yeah, and the what's called it, Arms of Hope, but it's Medina Children's Home, they'll come get it.
And get it.
We just have now, to have it in.
Do you have the listing?
And that's part of it. After the agreement, they can't sign a listing agreement yet because they're still waiting on the orders. But I put it in writing.
Okay, I want you to do this. Oh, I'm excited. This is really exciting.
I will also be receiving the
go back and ask them to sign the listing agreement, but don't date it.
Well, they're gone now.
In the future, if you run into someone,
I tried that, but they wouldn't do it.
Okay, but if you always ask, let's sign this, don't date it until we get the orders or we get the letters, then we can come back and date it. Because psychologically, they have committed to you.
Yeah. But they signed this agreement for me to do the $50 an hour clean out and to be the listing agent.
So. Good job. Congrats. That's awesome. See, it works, guys. It's out there. You just gotta go and get in front of them and start prospecting. Cool stuff. Thank you for sharing. Here is the letter system entry. See, letter system entry, just a regular mistake, nothing fancy. And again, here's Reba's. Oh, hold on, this is interesting. Reba's address changed. What does that tell you?
She moved out.
Why did she move out? Because the house is for smaller. Okay? This is really cool. I love this niche market. It's so awesome because you can read between the lines and you know exactly what's happening. There's some signatures. This is the will that he wrote. And in the will, he names her as the personal representative. So remember, she will be an executrix. And now, and the reason why she will be named the secretary is because she was named in the will. And no bond required. And so she basically, Melvin left her with full authority. So she's going to eventually get independent administration, which means she can do whatever she wants. Make sense? Good stuff, guys?
Yes. What if you have the, what if you didn't leave her? You had a daughter and named yours.
also go executive.
He can do that. He can do both of them. He can name the daughter. That's the deal, you know, that's, if you don't have a living trust, have a will, write a will. And nowadays, you go to Google and type will templates. Oh my God, there's thousands of them. You can download one of them. And then what I want you to do, if you want to just do a quick will, download it, fill everything out, have somebody notarize it, put it in an envelope, mail it to, or record it to the court, or mail it to yourself, certified mail. Don't open it, give it to whoever the PR is like, well, here's my will. Open it when I'm dead, in front of an attorney, and becomes a legal paper. Or record it and yourself. Okay? It costs you nothing. I mean, near nothing.
We were just discussing, so, have you done this in Texas? Okay, so in other words, is it that easy to really get into the courthouse and get this information? Or are they going to want your firstborn child?
No.
No?
It's public record.
Because it's public record.
It's public record.
So they're not going to
want to. What they want you to have.
Questions, just the name.
What they do want you to have the name.
Right.
Or a case number.
Okay.
Okay.
You can read the obituaries.
But you wouldn't have the case number until you research it. You just have the name, right?
Yeah, the name. Just come up with a name.
Yeah.
Ask them for a computer so nobody's talking with you. It's like, you know, do you have a computer that can see private records? And they'll tell you, go to that computer. If there's three computers, I promise you, two of them don't work. At least one will work. And then once you sit there, you're like, okay, so you have a name of the deceased? Yeah, his name is James M. Smith. And they're like, okay, whatever. So they'll show you how to navigate through it. And once you know, just start playing with different names.
Okay.
And you're fine. You just need a case number.
Now, in my experience, I have gone to the courthouse.
Uh-huh.
Did those people get paid to give you the files? Because there was a line. We have to take a number. And I've done this several times. And it seems like I'm inconveniencing them from their job. And then there's only one computer working, but there's like 10 people in line. And then it's like they're negative about pulling files for you.
I tell you right now, I have never walked into a courtroom in this country. And I've been to many of them. They're all cranky.
Okay.
They're working sun up to sundown, they don't pay them well, and everyone is treating them like crap, basically. Attitude, yeah. It's like, I hate my job, you know, get away from you. Oh my gosh, one time in LA, this guy was really having a bad day. He came out of the cage, I call him the cage, because behind his window, he came out of the cage, he was yelling. And he was the one that controlled the probate file, so I just kind of stepped aside, and I let him yell to the people. I said, oh, no, don't worry, they'll get better. Ah, walked away. But yeah, so just be nice to them.
Okay. But that is what they get paid to do, right? I mean, they have to give you the
They're public servants.
They're okay. Public, yeah.
Okay. They
get paid to
do
that.
Well,
the nicer you are, the nicer they are.
Exactly. Normally. You know, the golden rule.
Normally.
It's the golden rule.
But they say if you're going down there, you really need to just plan on the whole day.
On the whole day, yeah. Because
you know what I did? I did this, I remember when I started, there was no internet, there was internet. It sounded like a really old man. But there were not really that much stuff available. So what I did, I go to the courthouse, and I will treat them for lunch once a month. The whole probate, I tell the ladies, hey, lunch with me next week. Ask them what they want. And I order pizza or something. And from as soon as I treat them for the first lunch, I'll come in and they will have a pile. I don't even have to pull anything. They'll say, it goes, yeah, it's a pile, I got it. But now they grab my pile, sat outside, went through the whole thing. And I always put them back in order. So I kind of, you know, again, this is the golden rule. And I had people were like, who the heck is that guy? I just didn't say anything. I just treat him nice. Yeah, but good stuff?
Yeah.
All right, so we do have a system. Do you have any questions for me before I tell you what we have? Okay? You guys interested in listening to the system that we have? Because if not, I'm done. All right, so let's talk about the system that we got. It's called the Ultimate Probate Real Estate System. This is basically a whole program from A to Z. It's an online training, so you don't have to go anywhere. We do have a follow-up live event, but you don't have to go. You do this at home or from your office, you see the computer. We will send you all the hard copies. We'll send you the training manual along with the audio program and digital files. We also have a marketing program. I think this is what most realtors really appreciate from the whole system, because it's all done for you. The handouts are built for you. Flyers are built for you. We give you samples of business cards, samples of triflex. It's the whole thing is already done. All you do is you take the file, upload it, change your picture, put your picture, your company name, print, and go.
Yeah.
It's a plug and play system, literally. And right now we're evolving to the next thing, which is now we're doing an online marketing funnel, working on it. This is so exciting because now we're really be doing everything for you guys. All you have to do is send a little postcard. That's it. And as soon as they're on the funnel, everything is automated. So that's what we're working for you guys. That will take about another maybe 2 months. But it's cool. So this is really the most powerful piece of it. Now you'll have a certification. This is an actual certification. This is not recognized by NAR. The only certifications that NAR recognize are the certifications that they own. If they own it, then they're recognized. It's a business. That's what they are. So what is happening through our certification is a lot of the courthouses across the country are beginning to recognize people who are going through our program. And in some courthouses, they tell the realtor if they're not certified, they say, go down and get your certification, your CPRS. So really, that is better than anything. If the judge is saying, we want you to come in because you're not knowledgeable enough, so that's pretty cool stuff. We will have a follow-up. This is kind of a follow-up live event that we do every time we go to a new market. This is kind of a like hands-on thing. So you take all your knowledge from online training, you learn the whole thing, and then I'm coming back, I believe it's in May, Louis, what day is it? I'm coming back here to Texas. I'm gonna be in Dallas and Houston because we have so many markets, we pick the two big cities. How long is the drive from here to Houston, just curiosity?
3 to 4 hours.
It's worth it. If you guys want to talk to me again, because I'll be the one doing those trainings. So on that day, what I do is I literally ask you, okay, what did you watch the videos? Hopefully you said, yes, I did. And if you say no, I'm like, okay, don't worry. It won't be no, you still have reasons. So we'll go over to certain scenarios. This is when I go, okay, let's do some role playing. And I break people into groups and we do PR journey. We do the, sometimes I play the role of the attorney. You guys will play with me. So it's role playing hands-on. That's the follow-up, which you can get on our videos. It's really hard to do that. So highly recommend if you guys can make it. At the end of the live training, I usually give a marketing critique certificate, which is just a certificate that I give you guys. And I'll say, okay, you have 8 weeks to send me something. Go back, even if you just change the picture name, I don't care if you use our templates or if you tweak it. And if you want feedback, send it to me and I'll call you back and let you know what I think of it. So it's another set of eyes looking at your marketing and we'll give you one of those. And then you're also gonna have to be part of the Cypress community membership, which is the tools that we built. So that's the entire system that we have together. Does it make sense so far? All right, so your training is online. Your live training is a hands-on day. It's the follow-up to it. It's an optional. So to get into your live training, you go to MTI Education. You click on this sign-in button right here, and it takes you to the portal. They are total 10 videos. They average about 45 minutes on average. I think the long one might be about an hour and a half, which is chapter 6, is all marketing. I spent a lot of time working on that. The shortest one is about 25 minutes. And you can do these in a day. I don't recommend it to do it in one day. I think you should at least to split it half and half. Because you gotta retain the information, okay? So take a couple of days. You also have coaching calls recorded right here. You have access to all your training information, training manual and everything here. And you take your certification exam right here. So you click on take exam. It's 25 questions, true, false, pretty straightforward. Of course, you can go back and look at your notes. So the passing rate is really, really high, where 95% of the people pass the first time around. If for some reason you missed a question here and there, we'll let you retake it. There's no additional fees. It's just, this is a lifetime certification. Once you have it, it's yours. Coming from the educational background, that doesn't make any sense to me. It's like if I went to get my college degree and they say, okay, you gotta pay me now every year for having your college degree. That doesn't make any sense. So this is a lifetime certification. I'm coming back on May 3rd, Wednesday, in the Grapevine, Texas. So, but I'll be here in Houston on May 5th. So take a note of it. Maybe you guys can carpool together coming up. And we start at 8:30 in the morning. Class begins at 9 and we end around 5. I end around 4:15, really. That's probably the time I end. And it all depends. If you have questions, I'll stick around until the end and help you out. My goal is to make sure that before you leave, you feel more comfortable. Because, you know, if you're not familiar with this niche, it gets a little scary sometimes, you know. So that day is just to get all the nerves out and just go out there. Try it out. You're not going to hurt anyone, trust me. You'll be fine. Okay? Now, this is what you're going to learn with this program. You're going to learn how to generate listing opportunities using Probit, Living Trust, and Guardianship Leads, how to identify the best leads, start prospecting and motivating executives and administrators, the 5 proven steps to get an appointment with an executive or administrator and list their real estate, the fastest strategies to quickly spot the best Probit file to work with and get results, and how to identify the executives and administrators who are ready to sell now. You're also going to learn how to create and apply marketing strategies that are most effective when listing Probit properties, how to contact and communicate with attorneys and get access to their Probit property inventory. So we're going to talk about attorneys, how to get into the inventory, how to build those relationships, how to set your prospecting timeline to make sure you get results right away, how to get cash advances for administrators and executors and get paid for helping them. There's a company in Northern California called Inheritance Funding. So I'm going to teach you how you can become a broker for them. So it's another stream of income. So how to become a broker for them? Because sometimes these executives and beneficiaries, they need cash right away. So you put them in contact and they do cash advances to them. And you can get up to 7% of whatever they get. It's a pretty cool, program they have. And how to buy personal property for pennies on the dollar. A lot of the students, they were calling me and saying, hey, how do I negotiate personal property? So we've added this section to the program. So now you can benefit from buying personal property. I bought an entire house, everything, for $600, including the car park in the driveway. I found a dining table worth $14,000. I had to rethink. I spent $3,000 on it, but it was an old piece from the 1920s. I found radios. I remember those old wooden radios with vacuums, 40 of them, sitting in one room. And the personal representative, it was his best friend, and he lived in San Francisco. The house was in San Pedro, so he just wanted to just move on, sell the house. So that was a sport. I was a loser. So I'm going to teach you how to do that stuff. Now, this is called the Cypress Community. The way this works, these are the tools that our successful people use all the time. We start with a weekly coaching call. Every Wednesday at 1 o'clock Pacific Standard Time, it'll be 3 o'clock your time, we'll have one of our coaches. His name is Jack O'Neill. And he's been in the business for almost 40 years, done hundreds of Probit properties. So he'll come on a live call, and you get to dial in, and now you get to ask questions. And those calls get recorded, and you will have access to the recording. Remember when I was showing you coaching calls on the little tab? So you can download those calls and listen to it. Because one of the things is we learn through repetition. That's really how we learn. You will have access to unlimited email support. Give us a day, 24 hours. We'll send you the answer to your question. The fastest way to get answers is to the Cypress community. So you will be dialing, you'll be part of this Facebook Cypress community, and we have over 1,500 people in there from Texas, globally. And now you can interact with them, build relationships with them. You continue having access to the videos, and you will have your own profile on US Probit Services. Have you heard of usprobitservices.org? Let me show you. This is a directory of professionals. They are in the Probit Services world. For example, when a person is looking for information, now they go to Google and they start typing information for them. So let's say that they're looking for Probit Services, which I did this right here. Probit Services, very generic. U.S. Probit Services is ranked number one, organically. It's not paid. This site went, have you heard of something going viral? This went viral in 2011. So it's everywhere, with blogs. I mean, there's so many things moving to have the high ranking. If you go to Google, it's still ranked number one. If you go to Bing, it's still ranked number one. Using Probit Services out of 15 million sites. So they have very good ranking. Now, the consumer will click on this link and they'll go to this site. In about a 6-week turnaround, they have a brand new redesigned U.S. Provost Services platform. And right now, if you go to this site, it will look like this. So now, you click on directory and you have the different professionals. Real estate agents, certified proven real estate specialists. So your certification is recognized by U.S. Provost Services. Now they click on that, and you can put the information. So I put San Antonio, Texas, just to see how many people. And as you can see, there's three dots. So are there a lot of certified people in this area? Very few. So you guys are just at the beginning. We come to Texas once a year. So this is why it's growing very slow, which gives you guys more opportunity to go out there and make more money. But let me give you an example of what this looks like. So here's an example of this gentleman right here out of Austin, Texas. You'll have your own profile.